हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास आई वाज डिस्कसिंग द फर्स्ट पोएट्री, द विलेज स्कूल मास्टर, बट आई हैव स्टॉप्ड ड्यू टू सम टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम्स। बट नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू discuss with you again the same concept in this video's class. I just would like to repeat the information again in front of you. Dear students, the poetry, The Village School Master, written by Oliver Goldsmith, I already had a discussion with you that. The poet Oliver Goldsmith, he was born on 10 November 1728. Dear students, he was an Irish novelist, playwright and poet. He was best known for his famous novel, The Vicar of Wakefield. It is his best known novel. And dear students, another is famous poem, The Deserted Village, appeared in 1770. I think this is the small information of the poet is enough for you people. Yes, let me explain the poetry now. Dear students, the poetry, The Village School Master, it is an extract. Extract means it is a selected part. Ardha bhaga ante theriyutha. It is an extract from The Deserted Village, which is appeared in 1770. Dear students, the word village in the title of the poetry clearly suggests us that the poem is set in rural area where the speaker had lived. And the present poetry explains a realistic picture and the speaker's sentiments about the teacher. The character, schoolmaster, which is presented in the poetry, might be poet's teacher. The character which we can see in this poetry might be poet's teacher, Thomas Wilde. We are going to see the poet's teacher, Thomas Wilde, in this poetry. That kind of sentiment, that kind of attachment about that teacher he has given in this poetry. The poetry tells us that the characteristics of the schoolmaster, that schoolmaster who is respected by all the villagers and by all the students in that village for his knowledge and interest in reading. The poetry also talks about how the things could change in the course of time. This is what the introduction of the poetry. Let me explain the setting of the school. The village schoolmaster, he leaves his little school in a small village. with the description of the location of the school, where the school is situated or where the school is located. Yes, the location of the school, it is the beginning of the poetry. Dear students, as we understand by the reading of the poetry that the school is situated, the school is located next to the land which is fenced by some rich people. That means the school
who observed with the concept of stern.
ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅವನು ತುಂಬಾ ಕಟ್ಟುನಿಟ್ಟಿನ ಸ್ವಭಾವವನ್ನು ತುಂಬಾ ಶಿಸ್ತಿನ ಸ್ವಭಾವವನ್ನು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬಾ ನಿಷ್ಠುರವಾಗಿ ಕೂಡ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದ ಯಾರು ದ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಎಸ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್ ಆಲಿವರ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ಮಿತ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಐಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲಿವರ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ಮಿತ್ ಐಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ I already discussed with you that he uses to explain the sentiments of his school teacher in his childhood days. That's why when he was a student, he and his other friends made many circumstances, made many events to put the anger by the schoolmaster. That means they made some mistakes. They made some mistakes in front of their school teacher to put anger. That means he and his classmates made some mistakes, and for their mistakes, the teacher sometimes he had become angry on the students. My dear students, the students of this teacher. They had learned to sense the mood of the teacher by observing his face. That means the students, they are well skilled to understand the mood of the teacher by his physical or by his face. The schoolmaster is a contradiction, my dear students. He was a contradiction. The other character of the schoolmaster is he was a contradiction. Contradiction means, dear students, he is not ready to accept the other's view. He is not ready to accept the other's talk. That is what he is called as contradiction. Yes, the schoolmaster is a contradiction. Although he is strict and he is disciplinarian and he is stern to observe. My dear students, though he was a strict person, he was kind and good humored. Though he was a strict person, he was a kind and good-humored person. ಇವನು ಒಬ್ಬ ಹೃದಯವಂತ ಹಾಗೂ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಹಾಸ್ಯ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದರು, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಹಾಸ್ಯಗಾರನಾಗಿದ್ದನು. ಅವನಿಗೆ ಹಾಸ್ಯ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಹುದು. Listen, my dear students. He used to tell many jokes in front of the students. The school teacher, the school master uses to tell many jokes in front of the students. Whenever he tells the jokes to the students, the children laugh with the concept of acting, because they just want to hide their sad just behind of their face. That's why for the jokes of the schoolmaster, the students just laugh with the acting sense. The students, if they observe any mark of anger on a teacher's face, if the old students of that school, if they observe any mark of the anger, mark, if they observe any, you know what, any sign or mark of the anger of the teacher's face, suddenly the students spread that angry on the face of the teacher. The anger of the teachers, they spread throughout the classroom. They spread the leaves of the handbill throughout the classroom. But basically, the school teacher was a kind man. He just consoles himself that if he had any fault in his joke or if he had any fault in his teaching, he consoles that it is intense love for learning. He says that, dear students, in the other part of this poetry, the schoolmaster is respected by all the villagers and by all the students. Everyone in that village, every person in that village is praising the schoolmaster for his great knowledge. The schoolmaster can write, the schoolmaster can do mathematics, the schoolmaster even can predict the atmospheres, patterns and the tides. My dear students, it is the ability of that schoolmaster. That means he can write, he can read, he can speak and he can do mathematics, and sometimes he can predict. Predict means bhavishyanudi. Bhavishyanudi. Uhisikondu. He can predict the weather patterns and the tides. Dear students, ಮುಂಚಿತವಾಗಿ ವಾತಾವರಣಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ವಾತಾವರಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗುವಂತಹ ಆಗುವುಗಳ ಏರುಪೇರುಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವನು ಮುಂಚಿತವಾಗಿ ಭವಿಷ್ಯ ನಿಂತಂತೆ. ದಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಲೆಂಟ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಟೀಚರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ The teacher can do the accurate survey and determine borders easily. That means the calculation of the borders and the survey. These will be conducted by the teacher easily. That type of capacity the teacher has in his school days. Dear students, the teacher can also debate intelligently, and he can do the discussions with the village pastor. Dear students, the teacher can debate. Debate means charcha. The teacher can debate intelligently, and he can do the discussions with the pastor. Dear students, parson, not person. Person means vyakti, parson means padri, dharmopadeshika, pujari. We can call many words about it. See, the teacher can do the debate intelligently, and the teacher even he can do the discussions with the parson. Parson means padri. Yes. The parson, who was greatly respected by his parishioners, parishioners means the devotees of the village, bhaktaru, followers, himbalakaru. Yes, this parson is greatly respected by parishioners, and the teacher can do the debate with this parson, and the teacher can do the discussions with this parson intelligently. The master, when he was making debate with this parson, the master uses some difficult words and big words and even emotional language to convince and to impress the the people of that village and even the person of that village. My dear students, when the teacher involves in the deep debate and when he involves in the deep discussion of that village people, he uses some strong words and some difficult words, and even he uses some emotional words of the language, some different language, to convince and to impress the people of that village and even the person of the village. The person, when he observes the deep debate and the deep words and the difficult words and the strong words and the emotional words by the schoolmaster, when person observes the all these things by schoolmaster, the person accepts the schoolmaster as a very intelligent person, and he respects and accepts the skill of that schoolmaster to use all those such things. Dear students, sometimes even after being defeated in arguments, Sometimes, even after being defeated in arguments, the schoolmaster, he can continue to speak. He is not ready to accept the defeat. I already discussed with you in the beginning. That is what he was a contradiction. If he defeated in debate. He never bothered about that and he continues to speak. Sotaru kuda matanna mugisada vyakti antandare a schoolmaster. And the village people wonder. They put shock. They put their wonderness. How is a small egg could contain all those things? The village people shocked about the schoolmaster's behavior. That means they put their curiosity for the knowledge of that schoolmaster. How can he possible to speak such words? How can he possible to put that kind of knowledge in his mind? And how can he possible to debate that kind of intelligence? That is what the village people even shocked for schoolmaster's head and knowledge. Though the poem, the village schoolmaster, it presents the happy remembrance, the pleasing remembrance of the poet about the schoolmaster. That means the present poetry, it just gives us the beautiful memories. It just gives us the beautiful memories of the poet about his teacher. The poem ends in sad tune. At the end of the poetry, we can see the sad tune. Why? Because the present poetry at the end, it just tells the present condition, not the past. Going throughout the poetry, when we reach the end of the poetry, the last lines of the poetry, they just present the present situation, not the past. That means the great fame and the name of the schoolmaster, that is neglected at the end of the poetry. The end of the poetry, that just forgets the name and the fame of the schoolmaster at the end of the poetry. We can forget the schoolmaster's characters and the location of the school, everything we can forget. That is what the poetry, I already discussed with you, that the poetry explains how the things could change, how the things could change due to the course of the time. That is what I already discussed with you. Dear student, at present, the school is forgotten, the garden is forgotten, the name and the fame of the schoolmaster is forgotten, and even the success of the poet, very received by his very, very honorable teacher. All those things are forgotten at the end of the poetry. This is what the sad of the ending. Yes, my dear students, this is the summary of this poetry, The Village Schoolmaster, and I have covered all the information through this class. And dear students, after this class, I just put the questions in the next class. I shall send you the photographs of the questions to answer. Yes, this is what the in-depth explanation of the poetry. We should stop here, continue in the next class with the new concept. Yes, keep watching the videos. Thank you, my dear students. Goodbye.